他也是从小啊是在中国有一段时间是专门学习乐器，那个时候呢我给他上过课，所以我知道他非常厉害。今天我们有幸一起来给大家讲讲。
Tom me when I was a kid at a professional girls' school, and he said there are big difference between amateurs and pros. And he said I was very strong at that time. I sort of agree, but yeah. So let's just start. I'm a little embarrassed.
I'm
not sure. Do you guys are very familiar with those two players? The black player is Tuo Jiaxi, 9-dan. He's an international champion.
他在九段啊，就是因为得了世界冠军才授予他。
The reason why he is a 9-dan is not because he played a lot of a promotion tournament, but he once you win an international championship, and then you can promote to 9-dan. Another player is Qiu Jun 9-dan.
Qiu Jun 年纪比较大，30多岁了。
Qiu Jun is a little bit older because nowadays in China very strong players are very, very young. So when Qiu Jun is around 30 years old, so now when the player is around 30 years old, it's quite old. He had won twice in second place for international tournaments.
这位棋手也值得给大家介绍一下。他呢在中国也是比较独特的。他不像英明明，他那个棋下的好，他英语也好，学习也好。那个邱俊不是这样，他下棋像一个怪才一样。
Qiu Jun 9-dan is very very special. In China, because not as other players, they are good at study and playing. But for Qiu Jun, he only plays Go, and he is very concentrated on Go.
好，那我们就开始摆棋吧。
Okay, so let's start. Tuo Jiaxi is playing black. This is a very normal opening, so we won't spend a lot of time on this. So for nowadays, a lot of professionals like to play this opening.
以前呢，我估计英语里学习的时候呢，是在这分头比较。
Yeah, when I was learning at my girls' school, normally we just play here, but nowadays it changed, so we'll see.
现在呢，是在这里挂角非常多。
Yeah, so nowadays players like to play this move.
那今天呢，这个邱俊呢是在这挂。But
today, Qiu Jun chose another move, his approach.
他是为了求变化，而且从后面事后来看呢，他准备了我们说的一招。
Okay, so this is his strategy because he wants to make the whole board complicated and a lot of variations. This is very normal nowadays.
然后大家加在这里，这非常多。
Yeah, this is very common.
Do
you guys know this opening? We have a, yeah, what's the name? Kobayashi. Yeah, so in Chinese we call it Xiaoling Liu, is the name of this player.
我记忆特别深刻呢，就是当时啊，也是因为在那学习的时候啊，是我那个聂云达他说的地方学校啊。
Yu Bin Nana has very, very good memory because he said when I was learning Go at my Go school, in Nanjing Weiqi school, a lot of amateur players and professional players liked this opening very much. A few professional players only want to analyze this opening because they want to use this as a weapon.
那个时候呢，我经常去聂云平道场啊讲课，所以我对这边呢后面的一些套路也非常了解。
Because at the time, Yu Bin Naidan went to Niamey Language School to teach very often, so he knows this opening very, very well.
总之呢，大家如果碰到对手要下这个的话，要当心。
Okay, so you guys gotta be very, very careful when your opponent plays this opening because there's a lot of tricky.
我看后来陶佳琪就不是很当心，就引出了很多很复杂的变化。Okay,
so according to the game, Tuo Jiaxi is not that quite careful, so it caused a lot of complicated variations.
我跟现在呢，我给他推荐一个比较简单的下法啊，就现在比较简单的黑棋可以在这里。
Okay, so Yu Bin wants to recommend this move because it's very simple.
白棋是普通的再飞。
And play this nice jump.
黑棋拆一个。
And extend it.
那有了这一步棋以后打下来比较厉害，所以呢，白棋呢不是在这走，就是在这里走。
So after this move, black has this block here, so it's very good for black. So white either to play here or here.
黑棋挂一下。
And then approach.
应了以后呢，黑棋马上在这打入。
And right now, black will invade there right away.
这样呢，就比较对于黑棋来说呢，可以避开很多的烦恼。
Yeah, if black shoots this, those moves, black can avoid a lot of complicated
variations.
Maybe you don't know the reason why black play those moves and then you made it directly.
是因为白棋压住的时候可以起挂。
Because now black can watch here.
黑棋有这几个子以后，这边的争子有关系。
Because black has a few stones on the left side, and then the letter is working for black.
实战呢，黑棋是二尖低挂。
So the actual game, black played here.
这步棋就是后面影迷，我就想起我们那时候练平道场里面的时候的日日夜夜，后面的变化无穷无尽。
Because of smooth, it caused a lot of complicated variations, and also it caused it make Yu Bin Naidan remember a lot of good memories back to the time when we were learning at the Go school.
起步的一步呢，就是白棋啊是在这里。第一就是后面复杂的变化。
Okay, the first game of a complicated game is this move.
如果白棋安定是下在这里,
this is the normal Joseki.
这个是当时小林柳啊，小林光一棋就下在这里。
Actually, the inventor of this opening, he likes to play here originally.
白棋下在这里也不错，但是就没有一整套的变化。
Okay, so black, it's okay to play there, but it will be very simple. It will not cost a lot of complicated variations.
实战呢，下在这里。
The actual game is here.
黑棋好像这一步是必须的。This
is black must to play there.
当时呢，为了避开后面一会儿看到的一些复杂的变化，曾经呢，有一些棋手想变化，比如说当时李昌镐曾经下的。Okay,
if black wants to avoid the complicated variations. Li Changhao plays here in order to avoid.
白棋呀。
And then white play here.
再点了这里。
And then peep.
白棋这些想法都是防止黑棋在这里边打。
The reason why white plays those two moves is because white wants to avoid this ladder, which is the showed.
如果 还有一个不光是飞，还有一种是贴在这。Another
move to avoid the complicated Joseki is to play there, and then.
但是黑棋没有交换了这两个，被白棋走了这，不是很满意。
Yeah, since black has no stone here, so now white can't just the pincer black, and those three stones are very heavy.
这个情况让我想起了我学棋的时候。
Okay. This opening makes Yu Bing to memorize and to remember the time he was learning Go, and he was like
very young.
Okay, so at that time, Yu Bing looked very special Qifu from Japan. It feels like you look the Bible.
经常有这样在比赛的啊。
It's very common to see this opening back that time.
现在这样的结论呢，现在觉得黑棋不太难。
So for nowadays, the conclusion of this opening is not good for black.
所以刚才大家看，我们后来演变了二尖高挂的时候，白棋小飞的话，刚才我给他推荐下，黑棋是先走的。So
this is the move he recommended before. So now black will not play here instead of black will.
如果白棋走这个的时候，黑棋就可以拿下来了。If
white plays there, and then now is the time to block.
所以我们回到这样的棋，也就是说，黑棋要避开的下法，避开这个战斗下法，没有太好的法。Okay,
so because of that lower approach, it doesn't have a very good way to avoid that move here.
哎，在这里飞，这是最经典的下法。This
is a very typical and a traditional move.
但是呢。 到这里以后啊，就白棋就是有很多的他可以去准备的招法。
Okay, after this move, white has a lot of choices.
变化有很多种。最初我刚才说聂卫平到场的时候啊，白棋是这样下。
At that time when I was learning at the 聂卫平 Witch School, the move was here.
是下在这里。黑棋冲。
And white push and black blocks.
之后呢，黑棋有虎在这里或者跳在这里。Black
either to play tiger's mode or jump up.
那时候的研究组。 主要专注于跳，白棋四，一起接，白棋这时候在这盯，我估计你能想起来了。Yeah,
a lot of players like to analyze this move better than this one.
也很复杂。It's
very complicated.
走到这里是一种。
This is one of the choices.
还有下来这里。
This is another one.
又下来这里。
Or here.
我们这个就不能一一介绍，它后面的每一个变化都是一个，应该说都是可以写成一本教科书。
Okay, so we won't spend a lot of time on it because every move we can just write a book about it.
但对黑棋来说，只要自己想对一步，白棋他想什么，他提前一天啊，他就可以进行精心的准备。Okay,
so after that move, White has a lot of choices. He could have prepared for which move he's going to choose the one day before.
所以我给大家推荐，假如不想读那么多的经典的书籍的话，那黑棋走到这里更为简单一些。Okay,
so if you guys don't want to look at a lot of books, then you can just play here. It's much simpler.
那我看霍嘉熙呢，他肯定是觉得自己也很有研究，他呢就迎难而上。但是呢，我觉得他肯定没有想到 Qiu Jun 现在用了实战一下。
Okay, so Tuo Jiaxi, Yubing believed Tuo Jiaxi prepared very well, but Tuo Jiaxi didn't expect Qiu Jun will play there.
这样的下法是在应该在我二十来岁的时候，九零年左右，九十年代的时候使用。
Okay, this move is was very popular when Yubing was around 20 years old.
但最近很少了。
But nowadays, nobody plays this opening anymore.
我觉得邱俊是最近一段时间对这个变化又重新的进行了研究。
Okay, so Yubing believed that Qiu Jun reanalyzed this opening very well recently.
最近比较多了。 除了在这家，其实最多是在这里下。So
nowadays, most players like to play this one.
我给大家摆酒，有些喜欢看，就是世界比赛的棋手啊，有可能能想起来。其实最多是这样，大家摆酒。If
you look at the international games tournaments, recently you can see this move a lot.
这样。
Like this, and then push one more.
这个变化是最近几年比较常见的。It's
very common these years.
这让我想起那时候我们叫聂伟平老师啊，他是比我们水平都高一点。然后呢，有一个说，当第一次看见这个的时候啊。 我们都不是很了解，然后呢，对一个形状非常有意思。我说，那冲完以后呢，我们当时第一感觉是个飞，这个是最起，就大家最常用的一下。This
is a very common move for black. At the time, Yubing didn't understand why Li Qincheng played there, but.
然后我问聂伟平。And
then he asked Li Qincheng.
黑棋。 白棋走到这里，黑棋怎么办
？If white plays here, what is black going to do?
然后是聂老师说，这棋切到这里就可以了。And
Li Qincheng says, now black should play here.
我到现在还记得，因为这步贴往回走啊，我当时是比较吃惊的。后来仔细一品，确实这是一个黑棋。He
was very surprised. Yu Bing was very surprised. But after he thought about this move, and he agreed this is a very, very good move.
对白的一方来说，这样的棋，下一手他有这样的想法。If
black doesn't play there, then white can just play here, and then white can just surround.
好，这打是先手，有这样想法，所以黑棋呢不能在这非常痛快的坚守。Because
of that move, so black cannot play here.
他就有这个好。
Because it still has that move.
但是你如果为了防止他的你
But if you want to avoid them, well, you could play here.
但是这样的话呢, 白棋可以冲完这一步虽然这个冲很难看啊,
but if you play here, then white can still play here.
它可以靠得上。
Yeah, white can play here even though the shape it doesn't look good.
或者这两个线索,
and then there are two centers in the corner.
所以当时聂老师说一贴他说走这个，因为往回缩一个，我是觉得不太，但是呢，聂老师说这样子，这个位置也不是太好，所以大家平衡，这是一个，这也是一个定式。
So back that time, Niu Yiping said this move and Yu Bing was very surprised. But after that, Niu Yiping said this move is not very good. So for this joseki, it's both black and white can satisfy.
当然，我觉得我们这些变化，他们年轻棋手是不知道的。
Okay, so because those variations are very old, so those young players probably do not know those.
但现在有一个就是说还没有一个定论的变化呢，就是实战的下托。
This is the only joseki which doesn't have result to say which one is better.
好像白棋只能是退了这个退。And
then white has to take that stone back.
大家看这个是一个基本的形状。实际上呢，如果黑棋飞的时候，白棋不顶这个，刚才给大家摆了一个定式。白棋靠下来，也能像刚才的比较好。
So back to the variations we just showed us, if white does not play here, white could also play here, and then it will be the same.
所以可以说我们可以从这起步，开摆后面的变化。哎，顺便说一下，这样的形状，扳着阵是必常用的。如果简单的退，让白棋跳出去。
So for this shape, we want you to remember this. This is the only move and a very, very important move. But if you play here, then you just lost a chance to capture those two stones.
作为黑的一方呢，里面从也因为这个变化呢，要注意有没有就这个尖要不要接。
Okay, so as a black, black needs to decide whether he wants to play here before that move.
还有一个呢，是拖断好还是飞的这好。
And also, black needs to decide whether to play here better or nice jump better.
刚才我说是一样的，但实际上也有一点点区别。
Okay, so it looks very similar, but it has differences.
在白棋靠的时候,
the difference is
黑棋其实还有另外一种选择。
So the difference is now black can choose another move.
黑棋可以搬这个。
To honey.
看上去黑棋很危险，但黑棋有这扳，白棋必须断。Black
looks very dangerous, but black can honey.
黑在这挖。And
there's watch.
这里面以后的变化也是非常的复杂，咱们今天就不要讲了。
Okay, so it will be very, very complicated. So we're not going to spend a lot of time on it.
如果飞呢？ 白棋有顶这个的选择，但同时黑棋拥有搬出来的选择。Okay,
so when black plays here, white has two choices: either to play here or here.
黑棋呢有搬，所以如果是脱了断呢，就大家就没什么变化了。Okay,
so if black chooses this one, none of black and white has choice, so they have to follow the moves.
就像这样。 他这盘棋实战，他是现在是尖了一下。
The actual game is Black played there before.
我的建议，这个尖不要随便。Okay,
so his recommendation is not play that move.
最后我们会看出一个变化，这个尖假如跟白棋这个力交换的话，白棋围住这边的可能性变大。
We will see what's the difference. But after that exchange move, the white is getting much stronger on this side, so it's more difficult to evade.
我建议不要接，但这盘棋呢，它是尖掉的，而这两步的选择呢，应该这样，黑棋白棋是白。For in a territorial
perspective, is better.
但是呢，黑棋呢，拥有外面的利用。
But black has some moves or some help moves outside.
黑棋在这行动的时候就获得一定便利。Okay,
so black can use some sentence here and invade. It's easier.
我想说，后面这个局部的战斗啊，非常非常常用。我觉得大家一定要把，不管是那个水平怎么样，一定要把这个搞清楚。Okay,
so no matter how strong you are, so he recommended everyone should know this every variations about this joseki because it's very useful.
应该说，如果是真子黑棋有利的话。
If the lighter is working for black,
那么这两个是基本上就是,
and then those two stones are trapped, are basically dead.
你如果要活出来，就只能,
because if white wants to live, white has to live at the second line.
白棋有些情况下可以爬坡，假如你爬坡以后就把这块吃掉了。Sometimes
it works. When you can kill the whole group, then you can live at the second line.
那一般来说，爬坡这个是不行的。In
general, it doesn't work.
所以呢，白棋只有一种办法，大家看好的手段啊。为了让这两个不死，只有一种办法就是。
There's only way to save those three stones.
第二点，可以吃这个，可以吃这个。
So you can either capture here or here. If the lighter is working for white.
如果黑棋真子有利，黑棋管在这里。
If the lighter is working for black, then white when black can play there, because this is the lighter.
我认为现在应该是白棋有利。
So he thinks it's working for white.
不然白棋就不行了。
Otherwise, black is not good.
那么，因为这棋很简单，只有这样下呢，下到这个的时候呢，黑棋只要解决这个争子问题，他就可以吃掉这三个。So
it's very easy for black. As long as black can make the lighter work, and then black can just kill those three stones.
对，黑棋肯定可以获得这个线索。
So we are sure black has this setting.
但是现在这个线索没有用。
Because now this setting is not working because you cannot kill those two stones.
黑棋进下到这里。
So the next move should be honey.
这样的形状啊，黑棋获得 honey 的线索是。
Okay, so because of those two moves, the purpose of a black is to get this sentence, and it's very, very common.
从黑棋从这开始，黑棋就应该计算到争子或者计算到这个班有没有用，这是非常常用题，大家一定要掌握。Okay,
so he said when you play before you play here, you should already know the letter is working for black or white, and you have this sentence.
如果白棋吃那个,
if
黑棋吃那个,
and if white capture those two stones, then black will kill those two stones.
这个图呢是黑棋好。
this variation is good for black.
所以实战白棋是打四完。
So the actual game is white capture, Atari and Atari, because white doesn't, it's not as satisfied of the last variation.
白黑棋这阵子就问题解决了。
So now the ladder is not working for black because there's a Atari move here.
一拐就可以把白棋撕了。
So now black can just kill those two stones because the ladder is not working because of this exchange move here.
这个结果啊，其实在我们的数据研究的结果里是有。
Okay, based on the national team analysis, this is a joseki, but it's very modern style joseki.
黑棋呢牺牲了一个段，但是呢把三个吃住。
Black sacrificed the stone here, but black can kill those three stones. So.
那这个结果谁好呢？
So who is better?
那我的回答呢，就是说如果没有这两个交换。
So his judgment is, and his response is,
我觉得黑棋不错。
If there's no exchange move in the corner, he thinks black is better.
因为将来黑棋的这个打入都有可能做。
Because it might be possible to invade there. And then to play here, maybe you will be surprised.
黑棋有这个拖的现象。
Because there's a center there, see? He gotta be a move.
白棋必须要再破一点。
So white has to kill the eye shapes.
黑棋将来还有这个点的身手，他先别往外跑。
Because there's a center here, then a black is just escape.
如果是这样，这块非常大的话，我觉得白棋。
But after that exchange move, maybe the invasion move is not working because you don't have that move anymore. So now.
你再打路，你无法得到这个选择。
Right, because you don't have this sentence. So if white has a lot of territory here, is white is better.
实战呢，实际上是这样。
So the actual game is like this.
但是这边呢，还是有一些线索。
So black still has some synthesis around this area.
所以这样棋的好坏呢，主要看这有没有将来有没有用得上的时候。
So it's very difficult to say who is better now because we have to know what's going to happen in this area. See, only one exchange move will cause a lot of problem for professionals.
再跟大家说一下。 问一下为什么白棋要这样想，而不是单下的？Okay,
so he has a question for you guys. Why plays here first and then Atari instead of just play here right away? Who wants to answer this question? Come on.
就是除了在黑棋走，你再走一样啊。
It's the actually it's not about the cut.
有关系吗？是不是没有关系？这走了这和打这是一样的。
Is it the same?
对方一扑一打，可以包过去，这样就便宜上面。啊，先把这个走掉。
我看他的回答已经非常接近了。Okay,
it's very very close, but still.
黑棋没有必要，先打是这个。
Yes, so black doesn't need to throw in. Instead, he can black can just Atari.
这样呢，黑棋在死这个之前又利用到了。So
before black dies, black can take advantage of this move here.
所以正确的次序呢是应该先打这个。So
the correct exchange move should be.
这时候黑棋没有机会走了。
So now there's no chance for black to Atari. So professionals are very amazing, right?
I can give you a 重点介绍一下这一局。我们那时候呢，在我们
So back that time, in the book, white plays here, normally plays there. And then Atari. And like this.
这样的定型是我们的一个有定论的一个想法。然后呢，接下来白棋最关键下一步。Next
move is very important.
能不能跳到这里，是这个整个结果的好坏的最关键。Okay. 如果只能走到这里，白棋就不一定好。Okay,
so this move is very important because whether we can decide which side is better is because of this move. If white can play here, it's
对吧，就这样的话很难说。这样来的好。If
white plays here, it's good for black. It's good for white. But if white only can play here, then it's good for black.
如果走这里，是可以打的。Because
there's still an invasion.
然后利用这个这样。那所以呢，我觉得这一步接很关键。So
he thinks whether you play three turn move is very important.
如果是这样，白棋要跳这个的话。
Because if black doesn't have that move, then white cannot play here because black can't just invade. Amazing, right? Only one exchange move. Okay, let's go back to our actual game. Okay, because he believes Qiu Jun knows this move because he's older than other players. He must know this analysis.
但是呢，他今天是提的这个，我觉得他一定是有新的感想。
The reason why he captured today in this game, Yubing believed he must have his own thoughts and his own reasons. And then a black Atari. Okay, this is this is the actual game. This is also Yubing's first time to see this variation.
跟刚才那个图比吧，黑棋呢这个头小，没有挺完整。
Compared with the last variation, the black doesn't have these stones here. So but black has this black is surrounded here, so black has a more potential. Compared with last variation, is similar. Okay, so. So whether to say who is better, we have to see what's going to happen in that area.
再怎么说，这两个交换黑棋还是应该是。Okay,
so back to what we're talking about is all about those two exchange moves.
白棋，他敢跳到这里，没有违和的。So
actually, black white plays here.
如果成功的话，应该是白棋形势好。
If
如果白棋成功了，就把这块围上了。If
white can keep this territory, it's better for white.
后面的战斗啊，肯定是围绕的这一块，会有进有文章可以做。So
in the later game, every fight will surround in this area. It's all about this area.
是让他拆一边。
Okay, black played here, and then played a shorter game.
这五间冲是白棋经营模样的时候经常用。
This is a very good move to for when you want to increase your volume.
如果这样的围上啊，刚才我判断过，应该是白棋好。
Okay, if white can just save every all of the territory here is good for white.
Yeah.
And pip.
没有，白棋是白棋是。Thank you.
这更灵活一点。如果接上的话，他。Oh yeah, right. So professionals do not like to just answer every move, you know.
转对。And
then you made.
And take here. And then jump. 下到这，好像，按照我刚才给大家介绍的情况，应该是白棋好。Okay,
so for now, as we analysis before, he thinks it's good for white.
但是呢，我们他们职业棋手之间啊，事情不是那么简单。Okay,
so between professionals, not everything is easy.
如果这里面就一点事情没有了。If
there's nothing in this area.
那当然是。
Of course, white is better.
他现在还要在这打。But
now, black seems doesn't want to agree with that, so black invaded.
因为这地方有白黑棋啊，随时可以加。
Because black can play that clap all the time, anytime.
今天要打是有前途。And
then our tower is the same thing.
所以呢，白棋要是在这儿杀。
So if white wants to kill here, and.
黑棋在这儿。And
then black will play here. And then the honey.
非常的复杂，也不能说一定。Very
complicated.
那白棋就要下决心，敢不敢杀到这里。So
white has to decide whether he is brave enough to kill black here.
刚才说过那个白棋的效果非常高，所以呢，他这时候让一点点，还不是太要紧。
So black white is satisfied for now. So even though I just take a little bit back, it's okay.
这个走势呢？为什么呢？黑棋尖，白棋立，黑棋获得了挂粘的先手。Because
of this move, and then black has this two moves, and then sort of protected the corner.
但问题是这样，黑棋还是不。
Even though black has those two centics, but it's still good for white because it's too big.
所以黑棋呢，是在这跳。So
black jumps.
如果白棋在这，if
white plays here,
我估计这双方就同意了。So
now it's okay. Everybody is happy.
但实战呢，白棋是在这。
But the actual game is, white doesn't want to play here. He wants more.
黑棋在哪接上？
And then normally black should play here.
白棋。
And then, white will protect here.
但呢，这块有完整。
And then it's a it's a finished territory.
这样也是白棋应该不错。
So it's still good for white.
所以呢，黑棋在这一上，它冲击这个方。So
now, black wants to attack this area.
所以说，碰到职业年轻他们的年轻棋手啊，赢他很麻烦。So
it's very hard to win a younger professional.
我这块空他怎么他都不肯给你。
Because for younger professional players. They don't easily give up any territory to you.
我这个地方啊，
Mr. Yu thinks maybe black misread, because he thought black will play here.
为什么呢？他是因为等他刺这一刹那，他赚的这个。所以呢，如果白棋得到这个先手的话，这个只是余形。Because
at the moment, when white plays here and black play here right away, and now it's sort of protect the cut in the corner, and the shape of white is not very good.
我觉得他有可能这样算。 他认为呢，白棋会打一下，然后接着这个。
Okay, so Mr. Li thinks the reason why black misread is because white will attack and then connect.
这样呢，黑棋把它做成鱼形以后。
And then black will attack and make the white shape very very bad, and then play here.
这样杀棋。
Black can win, can kill those five stones by liberties.
注意，白棋可以不打。So
the mistake is white actually doesn't need to attack there.
白棋可以单接。Instead,
white can just connect her right away.
如果黑棋现在这样打时，白棋多出一棋。
So in this case, white has one more liberty, so the whole situation will be different.
这样的收棋是双国黑棋。Okay,
so the result is a seki, then black will not be satisfied. I know even we can't read, I can't even read why it's a seki, but I believe that.
但黑棋呢，打是这个的话。If
black plays here,
黑棋可以收获这一些
，Black can kill those two stones，
但是是后手
，But it's a good thing，
而且呢也守了很多别的地方，这样的定型呢，他仔细判断应该是黑棋不好。Okay，
so even though you killed those two stones， but you sacrifice a lot of stones， territory outside， so after the judgment， Black is not good or not satisfied。
另外呢，在这个时候打吃的时候，白棋还有冲这个。Additional,
maybe white can also push here.
冲在这断。Cut。总之呢，黑棋呢，白棋不打这一下是黑棋危险。If
white doesn't attack here, it's very dangerous for black. Because I guess there's a tarring, so a double tarring is
So
when black only can push and connect here, then those two moves are not necessary for black.
实际上呢，在这个的时候啊，常浩啊，跟我一起买，常浩。
At this moment, Chang Hao Naidan had a better idea.
可以抓住黑棋的这个失误。To
capture the mistake of a black.
就是获得更好的结果。To
get a better result.
他现在还在冲。To
push.
黑棋必须打。Now
black has to block.
断。And
then cut.
因为黑棋没有。 这边没有还得到明确利益之前，现在这退了。Because
black doesn't get anything over here, so it's difficult for him to give up the stone. So now black has to play there.
有了这个交换，再冲。
After those exchange moves and then push.
这时候黑棋就只能断这个。So
now black has to cut.
因为你如果不断的话，你冲这个的时候。 白棋是可以有时间切的。So
if you push here right now, black, white will have time to attack here to capture that stone. Because next move up here is really, really big.
黑棋连回来也仅仅是这些地方。Even
though you connect here, it's only a few, only a few points.
所以我猜测啊，当时黑棋的本意呢，应该是断点。So
he's guessing the originally idea of black is the cup.
但是问题是，白棋是不需要打这一手。But
the problem is, white doesn't need to attack.
这样单接的话,
and then connect. It's very difficult for black.
我们看实战呢，白棋没有采用长号这些办法，这些没有走，又给了黑棋的机会。Because
black white doesn't realize this move, so then give black one more chance.
这时候就都走不到了。
So now you cannot capture the stone by sending.
对。
So which?
黑棋呀，白棋这时候必须接上。
So now white has to connect.
黑棋呢，利用这几个子弹在这边获得一些利益。
And then attacking. To get some benefit around this side.
白棋挡住，从这打开始主要是避了一下。So
it's necessary before of that move.
实战呢，黑棋是接这个。
And then Black connected.
从局部看，黑棋其实这时候还有另外一种选择。So
actually, black has another choice.
黑棋在这打。
To attack here.
再来挑棋。And
then attack here.
冲。And
push. I don't even know what's gonna happen.
白棋是不能在这接。
White cannot connect here.
虽然这个能加死,
even though you can net here, you can make net here. See, you can kill those stones, but.
但是黑棋在这虎视线。But
black has a this ascending.
这个选手你来不及加了。So
you don't have time to play here. Because I can't attari here.
白棋只有打出这个。
So white has to attari from this side, and then. Connect, and then the black will push.
白棋怎么？这样呢？白把这个弃了，然后经营这一盘，也是一个。So
black will sacrifice all of the stones here and concentrate on this area. And then maybe connect.
实战呢，他选的这个接，他可能觉得已经足够了。
So, the actual game, black choose to connect here. Maybe black thinks it's already enough for him.
确实，初初看黑棋确实，但是呢，我们这个职业棋手这个 Qiu Jun 啊，他非常的顽强。
Okay, it looks very, the first time it looks very good for black, but the children is very strong. So maybe it's hard to say who is better.
接上，补一个。
And then connect.
黑棋呢，接这个。
And then black connects.
接上面。这个接上以后呢，这地方能盯回来。
Because of this move, and then black can connect here.
托加西呢，看到这个结果，他在决定接这个的时候呢，一定是心里默默的对这个局面进行了判断。他呢没有选择刚才这些，他认为这样的图呢，黑棋肯定是认为是黑棋好。Mr.
Yu believes the reason why Tuo Jiaxi chose this variation is he deeply analyzed the whole board and Tuo Jiaxi thinks he's ahead.
他弃掉这几个子以后啊，也获得了很多的利益，这个角已经守住了。 这边冲了很多。
So after sacrificing those black stones,
如果是我的话,
So if Mr. Yu were white, he would choose this one.
那黑棋在这里,
and then white and black will play here.
白棋在这一块呢,
so now it's okay. It's,
还不错。
Okay, so black is better now.
我们再欣赏一下，我刚才来之前啊，欣赏一下职业棋手的几步棋，也是让我大开眼界啊。Let's
keep enjoying professionals' moves, and he was also surprised.
实际上他是在这种补之前，他先尖。
So before white plays there to protect the weakness there, white choose to. Sort of attacking, right? I think so. And then cut.
在这边是黑的硬手，他吃。
And asking black where to play.
这时候他获得了这个接的线索。
So now, white has this setting on the top.
最关键是这个时候，黑棋啊，非常的头痛。
More importantly, white gives black a headache.
为什么呢？
Why?
作为黑的效率来说，黑棋是很想在这跳。
So for black, of course, black wants to jump here.
如果没事情的话，你要补回去。If
nothing happens,
这个子对围这一块是非常有用，所以这个子还是先手。This
stone is it will help a lot on this area to protect the territory, and also this is a sente.
这块是非常大。It's
very big.
那但是如果走到这儿呢？But
if black plays here,
黑棋可以，白棋可以先打吃。
White can attack first, and then if
这里只有断吃。
You have to attack.
咦。And
then capture and attack. But there's a cook, I guess.
白棋补一个。
Okay, then I'll take it back and.
将来这有个打劫。And
then there is a call later.
那么你在这就只能落后手，再补一个。So
you have to spend another move to protect the weakness.
这边就有白棋了，下。Then
you lost the sente, so now it's a white's turn.
所以白棋有了这两个交换以后呢，不但获得了这个先手，而且呢，这个棋啊，黑棋只能吃在这里，没有下来的。So
not only after this move, not only white got this city here, but also black has to play here to protect the weakness.
这个便宜非常大，我相信一定出乎了Tuo Jiaxi的预料，不然的话他就可能不会再接在这儿，他选择可能这边更复杂的一些变化。
It's very beneficial for white, and Mr. Yu thinks Tuo Jiaxi didn't expect that it will happen like this. Otherwise, Tuo Jiaxi will not connect here.
最要命，我来之前啊，我看见邱俊是跳了上。Okay,
so the most surprising move is here, because I will think this is a misclick.
我在这里，金鸡雄鸡啊！未来只要黑白棋，大家看得到这个交换的话，If
white can get this exchange move，
那么这一块棋跟这块的杀气呢，有两个非常关键的点，一个点呢是在这加。And
if we fight for the liberty between black and white， this is very significant move。
还有一个点呢，是在这尖，这就过去了。This
is another move.
所以这样能跳到这呢，跟这个尖比呢，就还好了一些。Okay,
so Yuming thinks this move is better than this move by 2 points.
但看着这步棋有点玄乎。But
it's very dangerous. If black plays here right away, and then the black white cannot play here, but he has to connect, and then black can play here, but
这个时候白棋有指这个。
Yeah, white still can connect.
这个时候如果爬这个的话就不行了。
But if a white plays here, then it won't work.
它可以搬下。
And there's a hane here.
再打字。
And then there's a tari.
但它可以先挤。
And white can cut.
没有关系。
Even though you capture the stone, but you still cannot connect.
而且后数也没有关系。
And even it doesn't matter about the territory.
冲刺这个目前没有关系。
所以在这种
局部的地方啊，像我这样的棋手啊，经常为了安全，不愿意多动脑筋。但是邱俊呢，他在这种作为他职业棋手，他在这么精细的地方，他好两步棋也是好。
Okay, so for this specific area, for the professional players like Yubing, they will keep the group safe, so they will not use a lot of time or energy to just get those 2 points. But for Qiu Jun, he's very good at the territory, so 2 points are very good and important for him.
从邱俊从这开始这几步棋呢？下得非常漂亮。
So, those moves, those white moves are very pretty and beautiful.
这盘棋的形式呢，我就局势来说呢，我觉得还不能说一定定局，也许白棋好下那么一点点。
So for now, it's still even game. Yubing thinks maybe white is a little bit ahead, but just a little bit.
请大家继续关注后面的进程。我们今天的讲题呢，因为时间关系就讲到这。
Because of the time, so we're going to stop here and let's enjoy the rest of the game. Thank you very much. And thank you for
this game. 谢谢。